Good morning. I hope you're all enjoying this year's summit. In the 16 years since Mark and Michael began these annual events, we've experienced enormous change in our industry. Change that has driven innovation and progress across every aspect of our economy and our society. Amidst this change, Michael and Mark have been our constant, and it is an honor to be part of the legacy that they've created within Canada's telecom industry for nearly two decades now. During this time, technology has become faster and more affordable, enabling exponential growth. The staggering degree of adoption we have witnessed demonstrates clearly the enormous impact innovation has had and continues to have on all Canadians. Our technology innovation, underpinned by significant and sustained investments in our networks and infrastructure, is future-proofing our communities for years to come. Through our leadership in this regard, our industry is enabling our country to compete and succeed on a global basis. We are ensuring Canadians are connected to the people, the information, and the opportunities that matter most. At TELUS, by leveraging our world-leading capabilities, we are bridging geographic and socioeconomic digital divides. We are enabling remarkable health outcomes through better health information. We are protecting the planet our children are going to inherit. We are advancing unprecedented educational opportunities for our country's future leaders. And we are keeping Canadians and their information safe and secure in our digital world. But perhaps most importantly, we are building stronger and more caring communities where we live, where we work, and where we serve as citizens. Our progress in respect of technology innovation and the investments that we make in our infrastructure impact all constituencies within our society. Clearly, our investments in infrastructure represent social policy in that they expand opportunities for all Canadians. Access to wireless and wireline services is essential to the future of our country and our fellow citizens. We have a history here in Canada of creating social policy that enables communication through the public support and reasonable regulation of critical infrastructure. 150 years ago, Confederation was predicated on the advance of the railway. That vital infrastructure defined the success of a community by connecting it to the economy and the rest of the country. Working collaboratively with the government, that dream became a reality, and we are all the better for it. Today, as we celebrate the 150th birthday of our country, it is communications infrastructure that sets up our cities and towns for success. How? By connecting them to the digital economy and to the rest of the world. Through our government's renewed focus on innovation, we can leverage opportunities for dialogue, like today's summit, and do so in a way that forges meaningful partnerships and helps shape progressive policies. This increased collaboration is essential if we are to continue driving innovation that is so critical to the success of our country. Indeed, we need to ensure we maintain an ecosystem, including a transparent regulatory approach that complements the investments our industry is making to create a sustainable, successful, and friendlier future for all. To reflect on our progress and delineate what the future will hold, as well as the partnership approach needed to realize the full potential of our investment, I invite TELUS's Senior Vice President of Network and Supply Transformation to the stage. Lloyd Switzer leads TELUS's ambitious strategy to transform our innovative networks and supply chain and create the circumstances to ensure every Canadian is empowered to capitalize on the promise of our digital society. Lloyd, over to you.